the countdown to Sochi down to just 7 weeks now. And 2,000 calories a day, normal for you and me in a daily eating fist, but it's a pretty light day. For Olympic athletes, Olympians can consume anywhere from 2 to 5 times as many calories a day to fuel intensive training sessions. Usually, though, they eat pretty well. And joining us today to talk about Olympic meals and how you can make them at home, U.S. Olympic gold medal winning skier Hannah Kearney and Olympic dietitian Susie Parker-Simmons. Thanks to both of you for coming in.
Thanks for having us.
All right, so Hannah, you won the world opener last weekend, so I'm curious to know, what did you eat that morning before you competed?
I had yogurt, muesli, a hard-boiled egg, a slice of cheese, and a roll.
Okay, now that you rattled that off like it's a very consistent thing that you eat. Is that a typical breakfast for you, and do you tend to eat the same thing every day?
I just have a really good memory for food, especially because I love it so much. So you asked me the right question. I don't have one strict thing I eat each morning, especially when we're on the road. For example, that was in Finland. Sometimes we're in China. Sometimes we're in Russia. And the food that we have is whatever they decide to serve us. So luckily, I love a variety of different foods and make the most of whatever is given to us. But cooking is one of my favorite hobbies, and it gives me a lot of control over what I eat, but I don't always have that luxury.
Yeah, no, you know what, though? That's a really excellent point. And Susie, these athletes are on the road so much and in places where maybe some of the food is unfamiliar. So what are the standards that you tell them to look for that maybe the rest of us can also benefit from adding more into our diets?
So as they approach the competition phase, we try and practice many of the different dietary regimes that they could put into action prior to competition. So we might do a European breakfast, we might do American, Canadian type breakfast, we might do a Russian breakfast. So everyone feels comfortable that they can compete optimally with different foods.
Mm-hmm.
We also take chefs away with us.
Give us an idea of what a Russian breakfast might be like.
They have a lovely pancake, actually, called a blini, that is that you put strawberry jam in, like a crepe, so Hannah would really like it. So that's very, very common, as well as the European style of having ham and cheese, some breads, and some of the pickled vegetables also sneak out there on the menu.
Hannah, you're from Vermont. I got to think maple syrup factors into this place somewhere.
Oh, of course. I mean, I can use maple syrup in my cooking. I pour it on cottage cheese pancakes. I pour it on regular pancakes. Actually, it's delicious in a plain Chobani yogurt. Some maple syrup is like dessert.
That sounds pretty darn good to me. All right, well, good luck here in the next few weeks, and we'll see you in Sochi.
Thank you very much.
All right, thanks. It is 8:21 now. So Susie is based out of in Park City, uh-huh. And I met her when I was there a couple months ago. She made this smoothie that was unbelievable.
I wonder what was in that smoothie.
Everything, but the main thing I remember was a can of pumpkin. So she
really?
Dumped that in, and then she added the other things, but the pumpkin gave it this really great flavor, so
Yum.
It was excellent for the fall.
I want all of it now.